We all know that childhood can affect your adult life, but does the type of childhood you have determine who you're going to be as an adult? Find out my thoughts coming right at you now on Charles Hurst Reinvention. You've seen it before many times. Adults who are severely affected still from their childhood. There are happy childhoods and sad childhoods. Wonderful and tragic. Some children grow up being bullied constantly in school. Some by their own parents. A few sad cases are severely abused. But the question is your adult life determined already by the type of childhood you did have? And can you do anything about it? Let's take two different examples of two childhoods. One child has parents who are still together, parents who love him, and everything seems to be in perfect order, or at least reasonably so. Better yet, that child is highly athletic, always starts first string, is smart in his studies, and is already attractive to the opposite sex in junior high. He's a favorite of his teachers and popular with his peers. Do you think this child's gonna grow up with self-assuredness, with confidence? Of course he is. Do you think he'll grow up and be a success in life? He'll either get a good college degree or become a proficient tradesman, but either way, he's gonna do well. He's not gonna have anger issues, anxiety issues, depression, or the potential for substance abuse later in life. Now let's compare that with the second child, who comes from an abusive home, and then is abused in school because he's a target of bullies. He doesn't have to wait until adulthood to get his depression. He has it at 13 already. And because of this, he doesn't do well in school, is not the favorite of his teachers, and is not popular with his peers. He's not athletic, nor physically attractive. In that same junior high as our first example, the opposite sex doesn't notice him at all. And they won't in high school and college either, if he even makes it that far. Because he probably won't have the confidence to feel like he can make it in college or trade school. His path will probably detour down the victim mindset, and there's a high chance he'll have anxiety, substance abuse, and depression through his entire adult life. It's a pretty dismal outlook when you see that your childhood can determine what adult you're going to become. But in my early days, I've worked in low-end criminal-type bars, and I've seen this generational curse in effect. Bad children become bad adults, and then those adults pass those dark traits on to their own offspring. And the opposite is true for the children who come from better environments. Before my parents were divorced, I grew up in a very well-off neighborhood, and all the fathers who lived on the street were from the high-end professions. Engineers, accountants, businessmen. Their children went to plush, easy schools where they didn't have to worry about gang violence, then right to the dorms in college, and they too largely became engineers, accountants, and businessmen just like their fathers. So it seems like the foosball table is slightly tilted, doesn't it? And the fact is, yes, it is. But there's also another pertinent fact. You may have come from that poor and tragic childhood, but you can also beat it. And I'm not saying this is easy, and it's not just a matter of making yourself financially stable later in life. Getting through college with a decent degree or trade school is the easy part of the journey. It's the emotional reinvention that takes the most work. For if a boy has an abusive father, he's probably gonna grow up and be an abusive man, unless he takes action to stop it. If a child spent his school days being terrorized, it's gonna take a great deal for him to reclaim fortitude. Trust me, I know this for a fact. And unfortunately, when it comes to tragic childhoods, there's many more failures than there are success stories. I have seen it over and over with chronic anxiety patients, even in their late 60s, on my treatment tables in the world of physical therapy, all stemming back from horrific childhoods. But the fact is, there's also successes. There are people who escape from their past, and it takes a great deal of mental and sometimes physical effort. And it may not be fair that you have to engage in all this effort when compared to the adult who came from a better background. And life doesn't care much about fair now, does it? If you came from a childhood that had a lot of hostility, you're gonna have later anger issues to deal with. You're probably also gonna have many symptoms of anxiety and depression, but all of these can be addressed and overcome. And it doesn't happen in a day. It took me until the age of 40, and I still have to stay on my emotional program, what I call the mind workout, because if I don't, these symptoms will reoccur. It's something that I have to do as part of my holistic program that maybe somebody else doesn't have to do. And that's okay, that was the lot I was given. And if you were a victim as a childhood of severe bullying, you can overcome this victim mindset as well. I highly recommend the combative arts such as jiu-jitsu, Thai boxing, and boxing, or just join an MMA school because they have all of that. Gaining physical fortitude, especially learning how to defend yourself, will complement your emotional program. And your emotional program should consist of yoga, some sort of meditation, and the constant practice of forgiveness. This will reduce chronic anger and chronic depression. And if you've become a substance abuser because of your dark childhood, you simply need to stop, whether it's alcohol or drugs. Because if you remain an addict, there's not much that's going to help you. But you are constantly attacking the physical plane and the emotional plane to bring yourself to a state of holistic health. And you also advance your career and become as successful as you possibly can. Have you ever heard the adage, living well is the best revenge? That is very true. But living well in a state of physical strength and emotional calm, that is even better revenge. And understand, you probably won't reach a state where you can say you're 100% cured from your bad childhood. For me, I still have periodic depression about 20-30% of the time at worst, but I used to have it 90% of the time. I can live with 70-80% good. That is a win. That is beating your childhood. So the question is, why don't most people beat their tragic childhoods? After all, I just gave some pretty simple things to do. The only caveat is you have to do them consistently. And the answer is because most people don't know what to do. You have to understand the concept of neuroplasticity, which in medical terms is your neural wiring in your brain. It's your thought patterns, complemented by your beliefs. When you're brought from childhood to be depressed, to be angry, to suffer from anxiety, to have low self-esteem, to be afraid, this becomes a physical neural programming in your mental mindset. It's like a well-worn trail that your brain constantly goes down because it's the easiest path. And the only way to change it is to rewire your mind with different thought patterns. You're literally forming new trails in your brain, but most people never even get to that. They've been conditioned in their thoughts that this is the way it is, this is the way they are brought up, and they stay there. Because a body at rest tends to stay at rest, and so does a mind. So if you feel like you've been dealt a tragic adulthood because of an even more tragic childhood, you have to condition your mind now to understand that it doesn't have to be this way. It isn't a law, it isn't a rule. It's not fair that somebody put you on the wrong trail when you were young, but you can navigate and find the right one and walk with others towards that greatness that awaits you too. I'm Charles Hurst, author of The Shepherd and the Running Wolf, A Path to Forgiveness on the Pacific Crest Trail. That and other works are found on Amazon. See the link in the description below. I don't ask for donations. You buy one of my books for a couple bucks and you'll get something of great value in return, for that is the capitalistic way. If you're ready to join our tribe of excellence, hit that subscribe, tap the like, and smash the bell, and I will see you at the next sunrise.